What's happening at the border matters. Today, we've learned almost 2,000 children were separated from their families in just over a month. That number continues to grow. Attorney General Jeff Sessions defended this by quoting scripture. So let's ask someone who knows a thing or two about scripture. Archbishop Timothy Dolan is here. Welcome to Primetime, Cardinal. Thank
Chris,
you for being
part
of the show.
Always a joy to be with you. Thanks for the invite.
So I was surprised that the Attorney General went this way. In terms of the instruction of what Jesus' message was about how we should treat people like those coming across the border, what's the message?
Oh, the message is pretty clear from Jesus. Look, I appreciate the fact that Attorney General Sessions refers to the Bible. That's good to see in a government official. The quote that he used from St. Paul might not be the best. For one, St. Paul always says that we should obey the law of the government if that law is in conformity with the Lord's law, all right? No pun intended, but God's law trumps man's law, all right? And St. Paul himself, who gave the quote that the Attorney General used, he wouldn't obey Roman law when it said that it was mandatory to worship the emperor. He wouldn't obey that law. I don't think we should obey a law that goes against what God intends, that you would take a baby, a child, from his or her mom. I mean, that's just unjust. That's unbiblical. That's un-American. There could be no Bible passage that would justify that.
Why is the church thinking about sending down a group from the Council of Bishops?
Look, you know, as everybody knows, the bishops feel very strongly that to violently take a baby from its mother's womb is wrong. And to violently take a baby from its mother's arms on the border, that's immoral. That's wrong as well. We bishops, we're not politicians, we're pastors. We worry about the souls, the health, the spiritual, the moral, and the physical health of those people down there. There are people, most of them, as you know, they're Catholics, they love their faith. We think we should just go down there and say, hey, we love you, and you're not alone, we're with you.
Will that be enough? If they say these people are here illegally, the law rules. In fact, Jeff Sessions goes further and says, I'll tell you what you should do, Cardinal. Tell these people not to come here.
Well, I would say that doesn't speak too well of the United States. I mean, you and I are within about a mile from the Statue of Liberty, which in my mind represents what's most noble and what's most sacred about the American dream, namely that people are welcome. Look, we bishops have no trouble at all. It's part of the same catechism that says we should welcome the immigrant. That same catechism tells us that a government has the right to secure and safe borders. We're for that. It's got to be proportionate, though, okay? And you can have secure and safe borders, hallelujah, for those who want to provide that, while still maintaining that grand American heritage of welcoming the immigrant and the refugee. That's part of that. That's just part of America. And I don't want to see that spoiled.
And you don't believe they need to do what they say they need to do right now?
No, I don't think so. If they want to be safe in interviewing and screening immigrants, fine, no doubt about it. If they want to take a baby from the arms of his mother and separate the two, that's wrong. I don't care where you're at, what time and what condition. That just goes against, you don't have to read the Bible for that. That goes against human decency. That goes against human dignity.
Yeah,
that goes against what's most sacred in the human person.
I had heard one of the things that led me to you as an authority on this is that I had heard that you had been saying, you don't have to come to me as a cardinal about this. It doesn't matter what you believe in terms of your religion to understand that this is wrong.
Yeah, you know,
morally.
I don't know if you want the Jewish scriptures, the Christian scriptures, the Quran. No, we're talking about the human heart, and we're talking about what's most noble in the American tradition. You don't even have to be a believer to know that this is not right to take a baby from its mother and say, get lost, and I don't know when you'll see your baby again. Not good, not American, not human, not biblical.
This is a key theme for Pope Francis.
You bet it is.
It was when he was cardinal down in Argentina. He's been talking about this a lot lately.
Yep.
He recently just, we'll put up the quote for people on the screen. He spoke, it sounded like, to this situation specifically. I know he was in Chile,
uh-huh.
And he's talking about that. But he was saying there's no Christian joy when doors are closed. There is no Christian joy when others are made to feel unwanted, when there is no room for them in our midst. I mean, it seems like he's speaking exactly to this. It was back in January, but it seems to apply.
He's become, Christopher, really the leading prophet when it would come to the defense of refugees, when it would come to advocate for the immigrants. And I'm glad he is, because he's doing what Jesus would do. He's doing what St. Paul would do. He's doing what Moses taught the people of Israel in Deuteronomy. And he's reminding, I think, us Americans of our most cherished principles of welcome to the immigrant.
So what do you say to the lawmakers? Because here's what they're hitting you with. I know you're not a politician, but if you want to find a solution here, mm-hmm. when the bishops go down there, if they're going to extend their love, they're also going to wind up addressing a problem. They say this is the law. They came here illegally, and what they need to do is stop, which is why the attorney general said the Christian thing to do is to tell them to come only legally, don't come illegally.
No, if I understand correctly, Chris, there is such a thing as discretionary implementation. You've got the law, and then you've got a prudent judgment of when to implement it. They can use discretionary prudence not to implement a law that would take a baby from his or her mom, okay? That's just prudence. That's just charity. That's just justice.
And to the people who say they're Christians, who say, I like it because it's her fault. She shouldn't have brought that kid here. She broke the law. She took a chance. And she's coming here. She hurts my family. She hurts my chances of getting a job. She hurts the lawful people who want to get in. This is on her. It's her problem. We're not doing the wrong thing. She did.
Mm-hmm. I would say they probably said that to your great-grandparents when they came here from Ireland or Italy or Poland or France or Germany. Some people may have said the same thing, and thanks be to God that our better angels prevailed.
They'll say they came legally. Nobody came illegally like now. They're all coming illegally.
And I would say if you claim to be Christians, you better read St. Matthew's Gospel when he said this is what Jesus is going to ask us when we stand before him on Judgment Day. When I was a stranger, when I was an alien, when I was an immigrant, you welcomed me. All right? So come on into heaven. Boy, to me, that means a lot more than any particular law that we're debating about.
You know, you spoke at the Trump inauguration.
No, I didn't speak. I prayed.
You prayed at the inauguration, and you spoke about Solomon and the idea of letting leadership come from the heart.
Yeah.
How are we doing?
Well, I think we might need that. You mentioned Pope Francis earlier, Chris, and you know one of his real trademarks is to speak about the heart. You might remember you were there. Mm-hmm. In fact, I think it was the last time you and I chatted when he was installed as successor of Peter on March 19th, 2013. He gave a ring call for tenderness. What the world needs is tenderness, all right? And I just say we need a little heart here. We need some tenderness. You bet we got some cold laws that need to be enforced in a very prudent, just way. We also need a good dose of the heart. We need a good dose of love and charity. And we need that. And we need our I think the America is asking our leaders to do that. You're too young. I can remember July of 1986. Governor's Island here in New York, Ronald Reagan signed one of the most comprehensive, just reforms of immigration ever. Now, if he and Tip O'Neill can get together, all right, two people who were very partisan, two people who were ideologically, you talk about a cleavage, if they could get together in their two parties to pass that comprehensive immigration reform, which gave great amnesty and created a clean path to citizenship, I think our leaders can do it today. Enough of blame, enough of retribution, enough of accusation. We need to get together and say, let's make this work. I rejoiced that President Trump could sit down with the president of North Korea. Certainly, I hope he could sit down with Paul Ryan and Nancy Pelosi and Senator Schumer and all the other leaders and say, we got to make this work. We owe it to our people. And by the way, Chris, our image is suffering in the world. You don't think the rest of the world is watching American border agents taking babies from the arms of their moms? This isn't good for us in the country that we love.
Well, hopefully they hear you, and hopefully there is some action on common ground, because everybody says they don't like this, but nobody's doing anything
about
it.
That's the problem. Yeah. Thanks,
Cardinal,
Chris.
Thank you so much for taking
the
opportunity.
All right.
Thank you very much. I appreciate it.